Christians, do you know why people wake up to preach? Do you know why people go on the streets to preach? Do you know why people spend everything they have? They carry a burden. But there are Christians who don't carry burdens. They carry needs. Some Christians, if you check them out in the spirit realm, they're like beggars who sit on the streets. But when they get in the presence of God, Father, I want a DVD player. I want a mobile phone. I want a new hairpiece, God. I want a bag, God. A good shoe, God. I want a plot of land I'm planning. And then you ask them, what do you want God to do for you? There's a certain car I'm supposed to clear. There's my children. I want them to accept. Oh, God, why won't you ask to know God? That is why when Paul is praying for the church at Ephesians, he didn't say, I pray that the Lord God of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ may grant unto you a spirit of building a house and buying a car, that the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, you might know what is the hope of your mobile phone and what is the exceeding greatness of having an iPhone Plus, and to know. No, he says, and to know what is the exceeding greatness of power which is at work within you, the riches of the glory of Christ, the hope of your calling. Everything we do must have a glorification of the Lord. How much do you spend in winning souls? Does your business tithe? Do you give your first fruits? When you say, I am a teacher in a school, man, drag those kids to heaven. Come on. Your job is because of the Lord. It has to bring a certain glory to the kingdom.